I was muted for a moment and now I'm unmuted. Hello, everyone. I'm Jack. Good to see you all and welcome to today's episode as we work through the artist segment. We're on Imagination TV this week. We've been looking at the theme of forgiveness, and it was really powerful to hear the kids start the show on the Tuesday and talk about finding ways to let things go, to overcome those challenges that have come your way, and then to forgive friendships that maybe you've had for a lifetime if something goes wrong in an instant, so you don't lose those friendships forever. And then as we reflected with our designers, we spent a special episode looking at This Hoodie Pays Rent. And we've launched this hoodie that I'm wearing right now to try and help people pay their rent around Australia and around the world. So $30 from every one of these hoodies sold goes to a hoodie connector who's struggling at the moment to keep a roof over their head. So if you're out there and you're struggling to pay rent, if you want to register as a hoodie connector, jump on amentoring.com and you can get $30 from every one of these hoodies that you sell. And then the other 30 bucks will go to help us mentor kids, to help the 1.5 billion kids that are currently being affected by COVID-19. And there's no question that we are in unbelievably unprecedented times. We either choose to find solutions or try and fight for solutions to progress through that, or we're going to be frozen in this moment and really be dictated to by the whims of a variety of different factors which are outside of our control. So we're doing our best in AIM's world to try and see some of that control, and for the kids that we're working with to send that message that as long as you keep putting one foot and keep moving forward, then you're going to be okay as we navigate through this period and come out the other side, hopefully having reimagined a world and hopefully having built maybe a fairer world that we can all live in as we get moving forward. So I'm pumped to hang out with our crew today. One of our artists, it said birthday, or currently it's mid-birthday. So in Australian time, it was yesterday, but in American time, it's today. So really excited to potentially sing happy birthday to one of our artists. And right now, we're going to throw to a quick video on This Hoodie Pays Rent so you can get a bit more sense of what we're doing with it. Head to aimmentoring.com and grab yourself one of these hoodies and let's see if we can support the 2 million people that are struggling with rent at the moment and keep mentoring kids around the world through this TV show and on the other side of it as well. Thanks to the YouTube chat line, those of you jumping on so early. Great to see 5YBR_ONY1 X, what's up? Not much. 5YB3R, what's up with you? Tom Derry, good to see you watching from Queenstown, New Zealand. Georgie, I'm glad that you dig the art in the background. I hadn't put paint on canvas until 12 months ago because I was so shit scared because my mum has been a baller as artist her whole life. So it's nice to be able to actually do some painting. And Benita Milner, yes, love the Friday show. Thank you for all your help, Benny, for helping pull this one together. And a special shout out to Dan Single as well, who's helped get some people on the show. So let's catch up with some of our artists and let's get this artist challenge ready to rumble. And we'll throw to a quick video to get that going. Andrew Levins, have we got you there? Gotcha.
Can you see me?
I can see you.
Coming through.
I can hear you. What's happening? Tell us a bit about your story.
My story is I have ADD in terms of my career. So I've been a DJ. I've owned a restaurant and been a chef for a few years. I still DJ. I've written a cookbook. And actually just recently I wrote my first ever, I'll show you, it's right here.
Yeah.
Kids book.
Oh, good.
My first ever kids book. It's actually about food, kind of. This kid is named Nelson.
And Nelson.
Hey, what's up, Nelson? You need to eat your vegetables because Nelson refuses to eat vegetables. He hates them more than anything in the universe. But in this book, he discovers that they give him superpowers. So that's, it's like cool, combining my true love, which is just comic books, and all the things that I've been forced to do to make rent and pay money, all my careers. So a bit of music, a bit of food, a bit of writing. I got asked to share my art, which apparently is food. So you guys consider food art, which is very convenient for me.
Yeah, awesome. Well, we're pumped to see what you create today. And my daughter's almost 2 years old. So eating vegetables, our tactic has been to create all of these other characters in our life. So Bill the dinosaur sits out in the trees and Bill really loves eating trees. So when it comes to broccoli, Bill says, "Oh, what you doing, Pamau? Are you going to be eating your broccoli today?" And Pamau says, "Oh, hi, Bill." And then she munches it. So
that's great.
Hey, go get them. We'll come back to you soon. And I can't wait to see what you've created. And we've got
fish burgers.
Fish burgers. Here we go. Zach Haddock, are you there, Zach?
Yeah, I'm here.
How are you feeling about today's show, mate? What are you going to create for us?
So I've been tasked with creating an art piece that has the value of forgiveness in it. So I've been racking my brain trying to figure out what I'll make, and I think I have a pretty good idea.
Awesome, Zach. And we work, are you one of the mentees in the program at AIM, is that right?
Yeah, I am actually. I've been with AIM for quite some time, and I've even went down to the university in Churchill to have quite a few of their mentoring days, which is really fun.
Oh, cool, Kaz. Well, good to have you on the show. Good luck with it and can't wait to see what you create. And I think we've got Giovanna Da Silva taking on the art challenge as well. Giovanna, how are you?
Hello, I'm good, thank you.
Awesome. Tell us a bit about your story and what you've got in store for us today.
Today I'm going to paint an artwork that reflects creation to me and kind of senses of awareness, which also links to forgiveness, which is the theme of today's show. My story is I'm 21 years old. I was born in Brazil and moved to Australia when I was 6. And I feel like that my background and my heritage comes through a lot in my artwork as well. I don't know if you can see my paintings behind me.
Yeah, they look beautiful. Yeah.
Thank you.
Well, very cool. Well, 25 minutes, I think, give or take, you guys have to create. So go for it. We'll come back to you during the show and check in and see how you're going. All right, we're now going to go into our first performer for today. So we've got Nations coming together. It's a voice, one part voice, one part machine. And we've got Nikki, I think's on the line potentially. And we've got Nat who's with us. And Nat, it is your birthday. So I'm going to just chat to a quick friend of mine down here whose name's Asterix. And he might have a special surprise for you.
I'd love that.
Hello, Jack, what's going on? Oh, well, I was just wondering if you could have a chat to Nat. It's her birthday. Hello, Nat.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good, thanks.
Happy birthday to you. It is great to see you on Imagination TV. Congratulations. Happy you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Nat, what does forgiveness mean to you?
I think forgiveness means moving forward and just living and feeling free to just live and move forward.
And what about imagination?
Imagination means no limits, which is also freedom.
Hemingway had a challenge that if you could write a 6-word story, you were a brilliant writer. So I think you've nailed both of those. Let's go into your song. Really looking forward to hearing from the Nations crew. And thanks for joining us today.
Thanks. Thanks for having us, guys. Yeah, it means nothing if you don't know what you got. You make it feel like Sunday, and it keeps me holding on. These flashing lights are temporary, it's not the end. And the morning sun puts an end to me pretend. I only wanna love you in real life, love you in real life. I only wanna love you in real life, love you in real life. Love you in real life. Don't lose your touch or your sincerity. Babe, that's how it's gonna be. Yeah. These flashing lights, temporary, it's not the end. And the morning sun puts an end to me pretend. I only wanna love you in real life, love you in real life. I only wanna love you in real life. I wanna love you in real life. Love you in real life. Love and feel like yeah. I just wanna love you. I just wanna lie and be loved now. I just wanna lie and be loved now. Now. I only wanna love you in real life, baby. I only wanna love you. In real life, wanna love you. Wanna love you in real life. I just wanna lie. I just wanna love you. I just wanna love you.
Thanks. Awesome. you have to assume there's a huge standing ovation in everyone's rooms, you know, as they're watching on their phones. And
that was quite daunting, actually.
It's gnarly, isn't it? With just no feedback or nothing to look at. Like, it's, but we got some love coming in from the chat line. Mm-hmm. Dan Single saying, "Nat Dunn, happy birthday, buddy. Happy birthday."
Thank you.
Lots and lots of applause and love, and people, I think, frozen just with joy and happiness. There was a couple of puppets dancing around having a good time here.
I loved that. That was my highlight.
Yeah, it's fun to dance with puppets. Hey, thank you for joining us. And Nikki, I might just ask you a couple of questions while we've got you. What's music mean to you being involved in this world?
Music mean to me being in this... What does it mean? Means everything, actually. Couldn't do without it. We'll never do without it.
And what about imagination, Nikki? Do you think that's something that can be trained, in imagination?
I think it is something that we all have, and I don't think it's about training it. I think it's about setting it free.
Awesome. Well, thank you both for joining us today and being a part of this. We've, as a small sign of our appreciation, we're sponsoring a song for $100 for everyone that's joining us today as well. So I know it's not a huge contribution, but trying to do whatever we can to help it keep moving. And if anyone on the chat line wants to sponsor a song, jump on amentoring.com and I'll go to our musicians as we keep trying to support everyone out there that are trying to navigate these times. So thanks, Nat. Thanks, Nikki.
Thanks for having us, guys.
Thanks, guys.
Good love. Big love.
Big love.
Levins, how's that burger going?
Guacamole, a bit of avocado with some cumin seeds and some lime juice. Yep. And I've managed to make slaw, a little bit of slaw as well. We've got some cabbage and white onion and lime juice and mayonnaise and rice wine vinegar. I've made a beer batter. Am I allowed to show which beer? It's cheap and it's green. You can use your imagination.
Yeah, yeah.
and then
non-alcoholic beer.
Exactly. You can use soda water. All you need is anything carbonated. And that makes, they should just call it soda water batter, not beer batter. But yeah, I've got the ling fillets in here and I've got my wok ready to fry. How much time have I got left?
7 minutes or 17, something like that. We'll come back in a second. Giovanna, how are you going?
I'm good. Painting with ink on paper, which is one of my absolute favorite mediums. It's so smooth and like satisfying, I guess. And black and white, it's just, I love the contrast. It's really bold and strong. So,
yeah, very cool. Yeah, I love that, how that's shaping up. Such a clean frame. So much of, I'm fascinated by the idea of framing, how we frame problems and look at what's inside and outside the frame. And yeah, it's a beautiful frame you're building for us there. We've got Marana Shukla. I hope I got that name right. Hello, Marana. Yum, guacamole is amazing. I agree. And I think Levins is taking on that vegetable challenge and putting it in a very good edible format. Is guacamole part of vegetables or fruit? Hey, Zach.
It's a fruit.
Zach, what's happening? Where are you at? Can you show us where you're up to?
So far I've just done a slight little sketch trying to understand how I'm going to draw this specifically. I think that I've done fairly well so far to kind of give the sense of forgiveness as a way to free you of certain burdens or certain like feelings of guilt that one might have if they need forgiveness. So
very cool. Well, we'll come back to you soon. Keep backing yourself. Hey, Irfan, how are you?
Hey, how you doing, Jack? I'm well, thank you.
Thanks for joining us on the show. Tell us a bit about your busy life and how you've occupied yourself since birth.
Well, I was born in India to a couple of Iranian refugee parents, moved to Australia when I was one as a refugee, grew up mostly in Queensland, and throughout my teenage years and in my 20s, I got involved in youth work, actually, working with Indigenous remote communities and youth work and refugee settlement. Eventually did a master's in communication for social change, launched a festival, did a bunch of spoken word poetry, which I'm going to share with you today. So done a whole range of different things over my life.
What's really burning, you know, those deep dark coals for you to want to get up and change things, you know, when you step up and go, okay, I'm going to do something. Can you remember a moment when you were going through your growth? Was it 12, 13, 16, was it 8? Like where you just went, no, I'm going to light up these coals and I'm going to activate them.
Yeah, I think it started before I even realized. I think I was maybe 6 years old when I interjected when a bully was like bullying a younger kid in my class. And I was like, you know, from grade two, I think it was. So it's just been part of my life. Injustice bugs me. And because I see us as one interconnected whole, any part of that whole that's suffering or, you know, being oppressed, then I feel that as a responsibility to alleviate that somehow if I can.
Yeah, there's a big difference from being bugged by injustice and doing something about it. There's a thing, a quote challenge for those on the chat line is who said this, that the only way for evil to prevail is for good people to do nothing. And I think often we freeze when we think we might be a good person who cares about action, and we might find ourselves in a bystander place, and then suddenly, you know, the world's moved ahead and moved in a negative way, which we're not happy with, but we didn't stop. We didn't stand up. We didn't stop that bully when we were six years old. So all power to you, bros, for being someone who's walked the talk, and can't wait to hear you talk with your spoken word piece. So over to you.
Pressure. Thank you. Yeah, you want me to start? Okay. So this is one of the pieces that kind of comes out where occasionally when I'm writing, sometimes my poetry comes out as a almost like a prayer sometimes. And this is how this one kind of started, and then it ends elsewhere. So we'll go with this. I feel you moving closer. Day by day, I feel your presence a little stronger. Like the sun ever so gently warming my room on those brisk winter mornings, I felt you even before you had dawned on me. You have the power to set the whole world ablaze in a moment, and yet you filled my soul with your light ever so slowly, so as to not hurt me, so gently you woke me, so softly you broke me. I was fast asleep in a deep, dark, dreamless state. You stood by and whispered. You never lost your patience, so unwaveringly stationed beside my bed as I remained unawakened. You never lost your temper. It was I who caused my own frustrations as I thrashed about in confused rage, and still you warmed my frozen heart and fingers into soulful animation. Forgive me, I beg you, for all this time I have taken to realize my mistakes and to seek your promised absolution. I'm ashamed for not having come to life sooner. I was lost, but I have you now. Dear God, do with me as you see fit. I lay all my affairs in your hand. I finally submit. I will bare my naked chest and let it be torn to shreds in the name of the dishonored and disrespected. If I be worthy, let me burn for thee. Let my life be offered up as a sacrifice for the sake of the sacred feminine. Let me offer myself up for the service and protection of women. How could you have let man make a plaything of your most sacred earthly presence? With what infinite strength and forbearance were you able to watch the desecration of your holy essence? Why did you allow us to trample the steps of your holy temples? Why did you let us enter and bring with us our dust and mud to your places of worship? What a cruel twist of fate when men are finally awakened to the extent of their blindness and for having been so wayward, for not having recognized your ever-loving, always patient benevolence emanating from the souls of women. Your most holy and sacred attributes you placed in women and then allowed mankind to degrade and abuse them. Why this most heart-wrenching realization? I beg you, guide me to that well from which woman has drawn her patience for all these thousands of years. Give me but a drop of it, that I may forgive men For though they know not what they do, I'm not sure they deserve your forgiveness. And I find it difficult at times to not hate man, to not hate my own hands, for not having acted sooner, for not having eaten the face of that man who abused her. How did we remain silent and consumed with the insignificant matters of life while women were beaten to death? How did the result of football games take precedence over the lives of women? I find it difficult, dear God, to not hate man. I beg you, give me a portion of the strength and forbearance you instilled in women.
Ethan, thank you.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Yeah, I don't want to jump off or jump from that space of depths of thinking. And I think one of my great passions in life is trying to cultivate thought, trying to be in a space where we can look at complexity. And you know, when we work with kids and we work with young people, that we don't dumb it down. And we navigate the gray space between black and white, between right and wrong, and between the extremes, yep. And we try and understand. And I think it's okay to, it's not only okay, it's as close to right as you can get to understand the pains of the past and to speak of them, and then to try and work out what action and we can take, you know, when you speak specifically about all of the inequalities that have been burdened on top of women and on top of Mother Nature, and finding that role to be for this generation of men to work out, okay, time to find a way to step to the side and create space. And as we navigate what a fairer world looks like, it's going to require a number of people who have traditionally thought power was bestowed upon them to work out how to give that away and how to share that and how to really build that equality. So there's plenty of comments coming in from online. We've got Tom Wenzie saying, Irfan, so good to have you on the show. Erman Duran from Nairobi saying, Irfan, so softly you broke me. What a line. Gentleness is one of the most powerful forces in the world. Kiara Atkinson, this fellow has given me goosebumps with his words. Dan Single, I'll sponsor these homies. Bobby Cunningham, beautiful. So thank you for taking the time to share your spirit and your thoughts and your ideas with us. Please keep sharing. Please keep writing. We require artists in all times, and in particular in these times. So thank you for taking us to places and thinking about complex things.
Absolutely. Thank you so much, Jack, for having me.
Pleasure, brother. Pleasure. Christian. All right, from that to burgers. Levens?
All right. Hold on. I got batter all over my fingers. One second.
Isn't that Australia? It was a great transition.
It was a beautiful poem. I've never cooked to spoken word poetry before, but I think I need to do it more. So we've got a beautiful buttered, toasted buttermilk bun. And then down the bottom here, we've got some slaw. At the top, we've got some guacamole. And now I've got some nice, beautiful pieces of fried fish. Top with a little slice of cheddar cheese. Boom. Boom. There's my artwork for today, teacher.
Perfect.
Do you want your burger spicy?
Yeah, make it spicy. You've got one more song, so you can have a play with it. You can bring this home.
I might see if I can find some taste testers in the house.
Perfect. I think that would be fantastic. Giovanna, how are you going?
Well, that poem was absolutely beautiful. It brought tears to my eyes, honestly. But I think I'm going strong with this. I'll be finished. Hopefully, you said I have one more song.
Yeah, we got one more.
Cool, perfect.
Awesome. Zach, you all going good?
Absolutely smashing it. I think that I will definitely be able to finish this by the time I need to. And honestly, I think that poem was definitely something to remember. Certainly very, very thought-provoking, and I do like it.
Yeah, me too, bro. Michelle, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
I am pumped to hear your music. I'm really, really looking forward to you bringing us home. Hey, tell us a bit about your story.
So I play the harp, obviously, but I love mixing ideas. Instead of it being classical, this instrument is so versatile. So I studied jazz over in Boston, and I play over hip-hop beats. I like to use it for... anything but classical to show how amazing it can really be.
So tell me that moment where you're looking at a harp and you think, mm-hmm.
And think hip hop.
Yeah.
Do you know, I think that's a very good question. I think it was initially probably hearing R&B to start with, but then when you're playing to a beat and you start hearing how hip hop progressed and they keep using samples or they keep using loop samples, and you think, if you could do something like that live, that'd be pretty cool with your hands without using a pedal, just kind of creating short sounds. But I started doing that and it seemed to get a lot of traction, but it's just such a cool instrument to just groove over to. So what I'll be doing today is just improvising over a beat, just soloing and just getting the vibe, you know?
Well, let's let you go get the vibe. I'm going to go grab a couple of my puppet friends who can have a dance along with you. I think Blue and Panger are yelling. I want to hear Michelle's play. So over to you. Looking forward to it.
No worries. Thank you.
Sick. That was what someone said. This is sick. Scott Leonard.
Awesome.
Yeah, Scott Leonard said, this is sick. We had Angus Gallagher say, lunchtime dance sesh it is. I have no choice. The beat. Marcus Bishop, bebop lines on a harp on a Friday. Has someone been picking up my Christmas list? Sammy Cherry saying, so groovy. Lunatune saying, holy smokes, hip hop wizard. And Hayes saying, this is awesome. So lots of love.
All the love. I am loving it. I'm loving the fact that people would dance to the harp, and that's what it's all about. Art is interpretation. It's fantastic.
Hey, what's your message to 15-year-olds out there that are trying to make sense of the world today?
Always listen to your gut. Always listen to your heart, and never do anything that compromises your dignity and your morals.
Awesome. And Michelle, thank you for joining us on the show. It's a pleasure.
My absolute pleasure. Thank you so much.
You're a champion. All right, let's go to our artists and see how they're finished up. Levens, we're coming your way. We've got a couple of burgers potentially. What do we got?
We got some official burger tasters. This is Archie. This is Tilly.
Hi.
Hi. We have some our official burger tasters.
This is Rainbow Bear. How are you, Archie?
Hello, I'm Rainbow Bear.
Tilly wants to show off her T-shirt. It's a classic.
That was a good one. Get that, aimmentoring.com, help heaps of kids. Shirt looks great.
But let's try these burgers. Should we try these burgers? Okay, you ready? I'll hold it for you. Have
a little bite.
Go. Did you eat it? Okay. Good work.
What do you think? Guys?
Thumbs down or thumbs up? Thumbs ups all around. Instant gratification.
Resounding applause.
Hey, no Levens, pressure at all.
Levens, when you think about working with kids, I know you've done a bunch of stuff with youngsters over the years. What's your message to a 15-year-old who feels like they don't fit?
My message is to stay creative, stay happy, try your hardest to stay both of those things at all times, and stay friends with as many people as possible. At all times.
Awesome. Well, thank you for being a friend and coming on the show and helping spread the word of creation and imagination and doing. And thank you for creating so much in your life. And it's been a pleasure having you on the show.
Thank you so much for having me. Bye.
Take care. See you, gang. Okay, Zach, where are we at?
Yeah. I am doing fairly well, just adding the final last little bit of shade, and then I will be ready to show.
Okay.
I'm not sure if you can see it from there, but I've went for
a to the camera. Come close to the camera. Let's
up
have a
to the camera.
Yeah.
Walking. So I've kind of went for an almost prison-y look because that's all I could really think of symbolicking. Like the freedom of forgiveness, because sometimes when you need to be forgiven, it can feel like you're trapped in this kind of loop of just feeling bad. And then the moment you're forgiven, you just instantly shed all of that kind of weight to bear that you've done something wrong. And then when you're forgiven, it's just all good, I suppose.
Very cool, Zach. Hey, thank you for joining us on the show, Zach. Have you got a message to 15-year-olds out there trying to make sense of the world today?
Honestly, I suppose life doesn't really need to make sense sometimes. So long as you're able to persevere and also just make sure that you're able to thrive in it and make others thrive with you and to just make sure that, you know, just make sure that you're happy and everyone else is happy. I suppose that's about it.
I think that's an ambition worth fighting for. Thank you for joining us today, Zach. It's been great to see you create. Please keep creating. And unbelievable story. And I love that idea of if we're imprisoned, being able to be released. And we should remember that, I suppose, on both sides of forgiveness when someone has wronged us and we have a chance to forgive them and release them, and vice versa when we feel like someone we've done wrong by somebody else. How do we build that out? So thank you, Zach, for joining us on the show.
Thank you for having me.
Pleasure. Giovanna, bring us home.
Hello. This is my finished artwork. I hope you can see it well. A hand symbol is something I use a lot in my artwork. To me, it represents
creation and the importance of making things with our hands and how much happiness it brings to your life and like the therapeutic benefits of it, I guess. Yeah.
Brilliant.
I'm pretty happy with it though.
Yeah, it looks unreal.
Thank you.
I love the two. Yeah, the black and white just whacks you, doesn't it? Like simplicity. Yes. Da Vinci said that simplicity is the ultimate sophistication. Like when you get something which is simple and powerful, which you've done there is, yeah, it really says something. So thank you for creating and joining us on today's show. And, yeah, it's been a pleasure having you here.
Thank you so much. It's been awesome.
Unreal. Well, that rounds out our week of forgiveness on Imagination TV. Thank you all for coming together in these times and taking on the advice of so many of our guests. What we're trying urgently to do with this show is to bring a mentor into every kid's life every single day around the world. There's 1.5 billion kids currently having their education affected by COVID. Some of these kids and many of them that we work with are struggling to be able to connect online, and there's a real issue with how teachers are going to maintain engagement with kids all around the world who already in the classroom weren't feeling like they fitted in. The job of this show is to try and fill that gap, to make sure that kids keep finding relevance in education, keep finding the joy and the magic behind it, and keep unlocking that imagination, which can help you see the joy that life can bring to you no matter where you are. So thank you for being a part of this show. Please head to aimmentoring.com before the show finishes and grab yourself a This Hoodie Pays Rent hoodie, or give us a donation so we can pass it on to the artists. And then a broader donation to support the show would be fantastic as we try and scale this out to 1.5 billion kids and be one of those groups that stands up and creates change. And I think when we go back to Irfan's poem or piece of spoken word, I think we should all take and carry with us into the weekend what happens when good people choose not to act. And we're saying as a group of people, we can come together here and we can choose to make this moment a positive revolution in education and a chance to reorder and reorganize things. So let's be a group of people that elevates mentors in the 21st century to become the new celebrities. So we have kids looking up to thinkers, to actors, to creators, to doers, to people that lead with positive moral compasses. And we do that, I reckon we'll have a much fairer world in the process. So thank you all for being a part of this show. And thank you for being a group of people that says, if not us, then who? And if not now, then when? Have a wonderful weekend, everyone.